Hi, it's Juliet from My City Plants. Today I will speak about and show you how to identify spider mites, how to prevent an infestation and deal with the issue. There is a lot of information I want to share with you, so get comfortable and watch. The spider mites are not the only dangerous intruders we have to look out for. There is also scale, mealybugs, and gnats. I am making a separate video about all these unwanted guests and how to deal with them. So don't forget to subscribe to our channel today to be notified right away when we post a new video. You do not want to miss any important information that can save your plant and end its struggles. The list of all the tools and materials I'm going to use in this video and where to get them can be found in the video description. As I mentioned in my previous video about mealybugs, for some reason this year, the pests are very aggressive. Last year we had no issue at all, but now few plants in our video studio are struggling with different pests issues. It also has been super hot in New York for the past few weeks, and the high temperature speeds up the infestation. I'm gonna use this misfortune as the opportunity to show you what the spider mites and signs of infestation look like. So let's try to understand how pests get to our plants. Pests can get and land on our plants from anywhere. If one of your plants is under the attack, in time, pests will find their way to other plants. The most active time for all kinds of bugs is spring and summer. They find their way to our plants through open doors and windows, even if we have the protective screens. They also travel via air vents, central heat and AC systems. The house plant that spends time outdoors for the summer can bring the infestation indoors if it's not carefully checked. Fresh produce carries a lot of different house plant bugs. We bring it indoors with cut flowers, fruits and vegetables that we get in the store or bring from our garden. So how we can prevent an infestation? Before bringing a new plant or moving the plant that has spent summer outdoors back indoors, make sure to carefully check it. The spider mites are tiny and their eggs are invisible to human eyes, so they're very easy to miss. If you were not able to detect the issue right away, it will become visible and very fast. Pests multiply rapidly. That is why it's very important to establish regular checkup routine once every 7 to 10 days. Just check the leaves, top and under. Don't forget to check the stems and topsoil. Stressed, dehydrated and dusty plants are the most desirable vacation spot for the spider mites. Basic plant hygiene will take care of most of the issues. We take shower and brush our teeth, right? So the plants need to be cleaned as well. By cleaning the plants regularly, you're not only removing the dust and help plant look better and breathe, but you're also removing the mites and their eggs. All you have to do is just wipe the leaves of your plant top and under and stems with moist paper towel at least twice a week. Misting your plant often with water will keep the mites away. Watch for the watering routine. You do not want your plant to be really stressed and dehydrated. Neem oil is all natural solution. It can be a very effective preventative measure. It repels many insects and mites. In my experience, it does not really work well on already infested plants, and that is why I'm recommending it as a preventative solution. The best time to use neem oil is spring and summer, when the bugs are the most active. You just have to spray leaves top and under once every 2 weeks. This product would be great to use on plants that were close to the sick plant to prevent any spread of infestation. The plants I have here, Alocasia and Bella Palm, are suffering from spider mites infestation. I'm going to use these plants to show you what the spider mites look like. And that's why I have my gloves on already. Spider mites are really tiny, and a lot of times they can be confused with dust. They prefer to start building their community under the leaf, which makes it so much harder to spot them. I don't know if you can see it, but you see all these little tiny dust spots look like. That's all spider mites. Spider mites can infest over 200 species of plants. And in hot weather, it takes just 5 days for them to go from an egg to an adult. So here you can see some of the signs of infestation. Leaves have lost their vibrance and they look kind of grayish. You can see some yellow leaf discoloration. Let me show you the webbings, which is like a definite sign of the spider mite present. You can also see it on the top leaf right here. Using your hands without the glove, of course, touch the leaves. If it feels like leaves are covered with fine sand when you touch them, the spider mites are definitely in. Using not only your eyes, or in this case, a magnifying glass probably would be better, but your fingers as well will help you to detect an issue faster. Earlier you detect an issue, higher chance you have to treat it and get rid of mites for good. Light to moderate infestation can be successfully treated. I will recommend to consider discarding the sick plant, replace it with a new plant, and get a fresh start. Heavy infestation is so much harder to control, and it puts all other plants in danger. Here is what you need to fight the spider mites. You need paper towels, spray bottle, mild dish soap, 70% alcohol, measuring cup, scissors, and bowl to mix the solution. I'm using the watering can. You can also use the chopstick to make sure you can mix the solution pretty well. So now let's talk about what we need to do and how to treat the infestation. First of all, we need to isolate the sick plant. Then we have to closely check the plants that were nearby the sick plant to make sure it didn't get infected, and keep checking on it at least once a week. Leaves of the sick plant that are heavily infested need to be cut out. Let me show you this on the bella palm. You can see this leaf? It's completely covered with spider mites. You can see how discolorated the leaf was. And I'm just gonna simply cut it out and throw it away. Now we have to make a special alcohol solution to remove and kill all visible spider mites. For this, you just need water and rubbing alcohol. I have about 30 ounces of water in this watering can, and I need to dilute 1 cup of 70% rubbing alcohol in it. This measuring cup is 3/4, so I'm gonna use this full measuring cup here. It's 3/4 of a full cup, and a little bit more, and I'm just simply pouring it in the 30 ounces of water. Now I'm going to mix it up and put it in a spray bottle. I think this is enough just to show you how to clean the plant. So now let's move to the first step of the treatment. I have to simply spray the leaves top and under with this alcohol solution, and then just wipe. Look, you see? Oh my God, this is all the dead spider mites. And just wipe the leaf top and under and remove the best, of course, I can, everything that I can see. I know you probably cannot see it on the video, but there is a lot of like little tiny spots. So now the leaf is absolutely clean. For leaves of plants like bella palm, which is hard to simply just wipe off, the powerful stream of energy sprayer can help to wash all the mites off. You just really need to, on the angle, and spray all the bugs off. By the way, guys, don't forget to cover the surface on which you are working on to protect your furniture. After the plant is washed, we need to apply a special solution. Applying this solution will prevent infestation to return and also will kill more mites and eggs that were not visible to us. We have a couple of options here. Option one, making dish soap and alcohol solution. This is what I use most of the time to treat the spider mites. You would need 30 ounces of water, 1 cup of rubbing alcohol, and a few drops of mild soap. Option two, the other solution I have successfully used in the past is Mite Massacre. The name says it all. It is all natural spray concentrate, so it needs to be diluted in water as well. I am going with alcohol and soap today, so I'm gonna make my special solution. Again, 30 ounces of water, 1 cup of alcohol, 70% rubbing alcohol, pour directly into water. Just need a little more to make it a full cup. Then a few drops of mild dish soap. I'm gonna mix it well. And again, pour it in a spray bottle. Okay, so now let me show you how to apply the solution on the plant after they've been cleaned. Using the solution, generously spray plant everywhere, leaves, stems, top and under. You really want to make sure you get everywhere, that the solution can reach all the areas where we were not able to wash the plant. Repeat this treatment twice a week until the issue is gone. I know you have a natural strong fighter in you. With proper tools and materials, you will succeed. Feel free to share your successful stories in the comments below. Like this video if you found it helpful. Subscribe to our channel to see more videos about plant issue, plant care, plant decor, self-watering planters. Take care of yourself, take care of your plants. Remember, people make plants happy. Thank you for watching and have a green day.